Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilpanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture on the solution and discussion on gate question paper in Mechanical Engineering subject. And this is lecture number 19. So we are going to solve few problems in the internal combustion engine from various gate question papers. And these are all the books I published earlier: Design of Transmission System, Turbo Machines, Heat and Mass Transfer, Operations Research, Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion, Thermal Engineering, Fluid Mechanics and Machinery. And I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures of all the subjects mentioned here. And presently I am uploading the solution for the gate question paper for the benefit of mechanical engineering students. Today the video lectures are more useful to the student. They can learn the subject at any time during their leisure time, convenient time. So you please subscribe the channel and use the video lectures for your better learning and to pass in the gate examination. And the first question is from 1998 question paper. An IC engine has a bore and stroke of 2 units each. The area to calculate the heat loss can be taken as, there are 4 options: 4 pi, 5 pi, 6 pi and the 8 pi. The answer is 6 pi. So we will see area for the heat transfer. A equal to surface area of the cylinder plus top area of the piston plus area of the cylinder head. So these are all the area through which the heat transfer is taking place. Surface area of the cylinder is pi dL. Top area of the piston is pi by 4 d square. Area of the cylinder head, which is exposed to the combustion chamber, is also pi by 4 d square. So we have bore diameter and the stroke length is equal to 2 units each. So d equal to 2, L equal to 2. So pi into 2 into 2 plus pi by 4 2 into 2 plus pi by 4 2 into 2, that is equal to 6 pi. So the answer is 6 pi. The area equal to 6 pi. And the next question is from 1998 question paper. An air breathing aircraft is flying at an altitude where the air density is half the value of the ground level. With reference to the ground level, the air fuel ratio at the altitude will be, there are 4 options given. Option A, cubic root of 2. Option B, square root of 1 by 2. Option C, 2. And option D, 4. And the density of the air at the given altitude divided by the density at the ground level, rho L altitude divided by rho GL equal to 1 by 2. That is what given in the problem. So the air fuel ratio, so the amount of actually air fuel ratio at the altitude divided by air fuel ratio at the ground level, that is equal to square root of density of the altitude divided by density of the ground level, that is equal to square root of 1 by 2. So the answer is B, square root of 1 by 2. The silencer, a silencer of an internal combustion engine, you have 4 options: reduces noise, decrease BSFC, increase BSFC, has no effect on its efficiency. So the main objective of the silencer is to reduce noise. So it reduces noise of the IC engine. The next question is from 1990 question paper. A 4-cylinder, 4-stroke compression ignition engine develops an indicated power of 150 kilowatt at 150 rpm. The stroke is 1.5 times the bore and the indicated mean effective pressure is 6 bar. Determine the dimensions of the cylinder. So we write down the given data. So indicated power equal to 150 kilowatt and the speed equal to 150 rpm. Number of cylinder K equal to 4. It is a 4-stroke cycle engine. And stroke length equal to 1.5 times the diameter. That is what the condition given. And the indicated mean effective pressure equal to 6 bar. So indicated power IP equal to PIM ALNK, which is PIM AL into small n. small n is the number of explosions per second. And now we have to convert. So small n equal to capital N divided by 2 for 4-stroke cycle engine. So capital N is the speed, capital N divided by 2 into 60. 60 is to convert speed, revolutions per minute into revolutions per second. So AL, the swept volume AL equal to IP into 2 into 60 divided by PIM N into K. So substitute numerical values, 150 into 2 into 60 divided by 600 into 150 into 4, that is equal to 0.05. Then, so A into L, pi by 4 d square into L equal to pi by 4 d square into 1.5 times the diameter, that is equal to 0.05. So the diameter now, that is equal to cubic root of 0.05 into 4 divided by 1.5 into pi. So diameter equal to 0.3489 meter or 34.89 centimeter. And we are given L stroke length equal to 1.5 times the diameter. So 1.5 into 0.3489 equal to 0.5233 meter. So these are all the dimensions. So D equal to 0.3489 meter and L equal to 0.5233 meter. The next problem from the 1999 question paper. A large diesel engine runs on 4-stroke cycle at 2000 RPM. The engine has a displacement of 25 liters and brake mean effective pressure is 0.6 meganewton per meter square. It consumes 0.018 kilograms per second of fuel of calorific value 42,000 kilojoules per kilogram. Determine the brake power and brake thermal efficiency. So we write down the given data. So it is a 4-stroke cycle engine. And the number and the speed equal to 2000 RPM, swept volume is 25 liters, brake mean effective pressure is 0.6 meganewton per meter square, fuel consumed equal to 0.018 kilograms per second, and the calorific value equal to 42,000 kilojoules per kilogram. So we have to calculate the brake power and the brake thermal efficiency. So brake power BP equal to brake mean effective pressure into VS into N into K. So brake mean effective pressure Vs is n small n equal to, for a 4-stroke cycle engine, this is n divided by 2 into 60 and k is the number of cylinders. And 0.6 into 1000. So 0.6 meganewton per meter square. We can multiply by 1000 to convert into kilonewtons per meter square. Swept volume is 25 liters. So 25 into 10 power minus 3 meter cube into speed equal to 2000 divided by 120 into number of cylinder equal to 1. So it is 250 kilowatts. So the brake power equal to 250 kilowatts. And the brake thermal efficiency, eta brake thermal equal to BP divided by MF into CV, mass of the fuel into calorific value. So 250 divided by 0.018 into 42,000 equal into 100 equal to 33.09%. So the brake power equal to 250 kilowatts and the brake thermal efficiency equal to 33.07%. The next question is from 2003 question paper. An automobile engine operates at a fuel air ratio of 0.05, volumetric efficiency of 90% and indicated thermal efficiency of 30%. So given that the calorific value of the fuel is 45 megajoules per kilogram and the density of the air at the intake is 1 kilograms per meter cube, the indicated mean effective pressure for the engine is, we are given 4 options: 6.075 bar, 6.75 bar, 67.5 bar, 243 bar. So the correct answer is 6.075 bar. So we will see how in the next slide. So we are given fuel air ratio equal to 0.05, volumetric efficiency is 0.9, indicated thermal efficiency is 0.3, calorific value is 45,000 kilojoules per kilogram, and density of the air equal to 1 kilogram per meter cube. Now air fuel ratio, we are given fuel air ratio, air fuel ratio equal to 1 by FAR. So AFR, air fuel ratio equal to 1 by fuel air ratio equal to 1 divided by 0.05 equal to 20. So the mass of the air equal to 20 kilograms per second for every kilogram of fuel. And theoretical air equal to mass of theoretical air equal to mass of the air, actual air divided by the volumetric efficiency. So 20 divided by 0.9 equal to 22.22 kilograms per second. and theoretical volume of air. So volume equal to mass of the air, theoretical mass of the air divided by the density of the air equal to 22.22 divided by 1 equal to 22.22 meter cube per second. So indicated power, equal to indicated thermal efficiency into mass of the fuel into calorific value. So 0.3 into 1 into 45,000 equal to 13,500 kilowatts. And indicated mean effective pressure equal to the IMEP equal to IP by VS. So which is 13,500 divided by the volume of the air equal to 22.22 equal to 607.56 kilopascal, which is 0756 bar. That is the answer we have marked earlier. So that is the answer we have marked in the previous slide. The next question is from 1990 question paper. An engine is used on the job requiring a shaft output of 100 kilowatt. The mechanical efficiency of the engine is 80% and it uses 30 kg of fuel per hour under the condition of operation. Calculate the indicated thermal efficiency. If an improvement in the engine design reduces the frictional losses to 5 kilowatt, so frictional losses are reduced to 5 kilowatt, calculate the amount of fuel saved per hour. Assume that the indicated thermal efficiency remains the same. Calorific value of the fuel is 42,000 kilojoules per kilogram. And we are given brake power equal to 100 kilowatt, mechanical efficiency equal to 0.8, mass of the fuel equal to 30 kilograms per hour, which is 8.33 in 10 power minus 3 kilograms per second. So friction power is modified to 5 kilowatt and the calorific value is 42,000 kilojoules per kilogram. Indicated power we calculate IP equal to BP by mechanical efficiency. So 100 divided by 0.8 equal to 125 kilowatt. So for the initial condition, the indicated power equal to 125 kilowatts. And the indicated thermal efficiency equal to IP by MF into CV. So 125 divided by 8.33 in 10 power minus 3 into 42,000 into 100 equal to 35.73%. So listen to the condition. So the friction power reduced to 5 kilowatt and the indicated thermal efficiency remains the same. Now mass of the fuel used under the revised condition we calculate. So IP equal to BP plus FP. So brake power is given as 100. Now the friction power equal to 5 kilowatt. 105 kilowatt is the new indicated power. And the indicated thermal efficiency equal to IP1 divided by MF into CV. So 35.73 equal to 105 divided by MF into 42,000 into 100. So rearranging mass of the fuel equal to 105 divided by 35.73 into 42,000 into 100 equal to 7 into 10 power minus 3 kilograms per second, which is equal to 25.2 kilograms per hour. So the amount of fuel saved equal to 30. Initially it is 30 kilograms per hour. 30 minus 25.2 equal to 3.8 kilograms per hour. That is the amount of fuel saved. The next question is from 1991 question paper. A 4-stroke 4-cylinder spark ignition engine having a bore of 7 cm and a stroke 9 cm develops 20 kilowatts at 3000 rpm. If the clearance volume of each cylinder is 50 cm cube, brake thermal efficiency is 50% of air cylinder efficiency and the calorific value of the fuel is 43 megajoules per kilogram, find the output, brake thermal efficiency and fuel consumption. So we are given the data. So diameter equal to 7 cm, stroke length equal to 9 cm, brake power equal to 20 kilowatts, speed n equal to 3000 rpm, and the VC clearance volume is 50 cm cube, brake thermal efficiency is 0.5 times of the air cylinder efficiency, calorific value equal to 43 megajoules per kilogram. Now the stroke volume VS equal to pi by 4 d square into L. So pi by 4 7 square into 9 equal to 346.185 centimeter cube. And the compression ratio VS plus VC divided by VC. So 346.185 plus 50 divided by 50 equal to 7.92. So the compression ratio is 7.92. Now we calculate the air cylinder efficiency. Eta A equal to 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1. Which is 1 minus 1 by 7.92 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 0.563. And we are given brake thermal efficiency is 50% of air cylinder efficiency. So break thermal efficiency equal to 0.5 into eta A equal to 0.5 into 0.563 equal to 0.2815, which is 28.15%. Then the output power out, I mean the torque output of the engine T equal to break power into 60 divided by 2 pi n. So 20 into 60 divided by 2 pi into 3000 equal to 0.064 kilonewton meter. So we are given 20 kilowatts, so kilonewton meter. And the fuel consumption MF equal to brake power divided by brake thermal efficiency into CV. So 20 divided by 0.2815 into 43,000 equal to 1.65 in 10 power minus 3 kilograms per second, which is also equal to 5.948 kilograms per hour. That is the answer to the problem. The next problem from 1992 question paper. A four-cylinder, four-stroke spark ignition engine develops a maximum brake torque of 160 Newton meter at 3000 RPM. Calculate the engine displacement, bore and the stroke. The brake mean effective pressure at the maximum engine torque equal to 960 kilopascal. Assume bore equal to the stroke. And the given data for the problem, so K number of cylinder equal to 4. It is a 4-stroke cycle engine. Torque produced equal to 160 Newton meter. N speed equal to 3000 RPM. The brake mean effective pressure is 960 kilopascal. And we are given diameter equal to the stroke length. And the brake power we calculate. Brake power equal to 2 pi NT by 60. So 2 pi N equal to 3000. And torque equal to 160 Newton meter divided by 60 into 1000. So 1000. The 60 is to convert the speed into RPS and 1000 is to convert the power, the kilowatt into kilowatt. So the answer is 50.24 kilowatts. Then displacement volume. So there is another way to define the brake power. So brake power equal to brake mean effective pressure AL N into K. So which is brake power, brake mean effective pressure AL into N, small n equal to capital N divided by 2 into 60. It is a 4-stroke cycle engine. Small n equal to capital N divided by 2 into 60 into K number of cylinders. So rearranging AL, the shaft volume or the displacement volume equal to BP into 2 into 60 divided by brake mean effective pressure into N into K. So substituting 50.24 into 2 into 60 divided by 960 into 3000 into 4 equal to 5.23 into 10 power minus 4 meter cube. And we are given AL equal to pi by 4 d square into L, which is pi by 4 d square. L is also equal to d equal to 5.23 in 10 power minus 4. So d equal to L equal to cubic root of 5.23 into 10 power minus 4 into 4 by pi. So calculating, so diameter or the stroke length equal to 0.0873 meter, which is 8.763 centimeter. That is the answer to the problem. The next question is from 1995 question paper. A single cylinder 4-stroke diesel engine running at 1800 RPM has a bore of 85 mm and the stroke length of 110 mm. It takes 0.56 kg of air per minute and develops a brake power output of 6 kilowatts while the air fuel ratio is 20:1. The calorific value of the fuel used is 42,550 kilojoules per kilogram and the ambient air density is 1.18 kilogram per meter cube. Calculate the volumetric efficiency and the brake thermal, brake specific fuel consumption. So we write down the given data. The speed equal to 1800 RPM, diameter equal to 85 millimeter, stroke length equal to 110 millimeter, mass of the air equal to 0.56 kilograms per minute, brake power equal to 6 kilowatts, air fuel ratio equal to 20:1, calorific value is 42,550 kilojoules per kilogram, density of the air equal to 1.18 kilograms per meter cube. So the theoretical mass of the air, so theoretical mass of the air equal to pi by 4 d square into L into N by 2 into 60. Into density, density of the air. So pi by 4 d square L is the swept volume. N divided by 2 into 60, that gives meter cube per second, and into multiply by the density, that gives the kilograms per second. So you calculate, so pi by 4 into 0.085 square into 0.11 into speed equal to 1800, n equal to 1800 divided by 2 into 60 into 1.18, that is equal to 0.011 kilograms per second, which is equal to 0.66 kilograms per minute multiplying by 60. And the volumetric efficiency equal to mass of the air, actual mass of the air divided by theoretical mass of the air into 100. So, 0.56 divided by 0.66 into 100 equal to 84.8%. Then the fuel consumption, MF equal to MA by air fuel ratio. So, MA equal to 0.56 kilograms per minute. So, 0.56 divided by 60 divided by air fuel ratio equal to 20 equal to 4.67 × 10⁻⁴ kilograms per second. Then we calculate the brake specific fuel consumption. So, BSFC equal to MF divided by BP, which is equal to 4.67 × 10⁻⁴ into 3600 divided by 6 equal to 0.28 kilogram per kilowatt hour. So, you carefully note down the steps and listen to the steps, and then you write down, you can solve the problem. The next problem from 1993 question paper. A 6-cylinder CI engine developing a power output of 270 kilowatts at 1000 rpm has a fuel consumption of 0.25 kilogram per kilowatt hour. The injection takes place over 20 degree crank angle with a pressure across the injector orifice is 100 megapascal. Find the rate of fuel injection in milligrams per second through each hole of a 4-hole injector fitted in the cylinder and the thermal efficiency of the engine. So, the given data, we have 6 cylinders, K equal to 6, it is a 4-stroke cycle engine. Brake power equal to 270 kilowatts, speed equal to 1000 rpm. BSFC is given as 0.25 kilogram per kilowatt hour. The theta angle of fuel injection is 20 degree. Pressure drop for the injection is 100 megapascal. Number of holes N equal to 4. And rate of injection per hole in milligrams per second. And we look at the problem. We are given BSFC 0.25 into 270 divided by 3600. So, 270 is the brake power. So, 0.25 is the BSFC. So, BSFC in the brake power divided by 3600 equal to 0.01875 kilograms per second for 6 cylinders. Now, we calculate 0.01875 into 10 power 6. So, the 10 power 6 to convert into milligram. So, kilogram into milligram divided by 6. There are 6 cylinders divided by 4. There are 4 holes in each injector. So, this is equal to 781.25 milligrams per second per hole per cylinder. That is the rate of fuel injection per hole in milligram per second. And the brake thermal efficiency equal to brake power divided by MF into CV. So, which is 1 by, you take brake power to the denominator, MF by BP into CV. So, 3600. So, MF by BP equal to brake specific fuel consumption into calorific value. So, the brake specific fuel consumption is given as 0.25 kilogram per kilowatt hour. So, to convert into second, we are multiplying by 3600. So, 3600 divided by 0.25 into 40,000 into 100 equal to 36%. So, the efficiency is 36%. And the next problem from 1997 question paper. The power output of an IC engine is measured by a rope brake dynamometer. The diameter of the brake pulley is 700 millimeter and the rope diameter is 25 millimeter. The load on the tight side of the rope is 50 kilogram mass and the spring balance reads 50 newton. The engine is running at 900 revolutions per minute, consumes a fuel of calorific value 44,000 kilojoules per kilogram at a rate of 4 kilograms per hour. Assume G, acceleration due to gravity, G equal to 9.8 meter per second square. Calculate the brake specific fuel consumption and brake thermal efficiency. So, we write down the given data. So, we are measuring the brake power using the rope brake dynamometer. So, diameter of the drum equal to 0.7 meter. Diameter of the rope small d equal to 0.025 meter. The weight is 50 kilograms. Spring balance reading is 50 newton. Speed equal to 900 rpm. And the calorific value is 44,000 kilojoules per kilogram. Mass of the fuel equal to 4 kilograms per hour. And acceleration due to gravity equal to 9.8 meter per second square. And the effective radius for the calculation of the brake power, so effective radius equal to diameter of the dumb plus 2 into diameter of the rope. So because we have rope on both sides of the drum, so 2 into diameter of the rope divided by 2, which is 0.7 plus 2 into 0.025 divided by 2 equal to 0.375 meter. And we calculate the brake power. So brake power equal to 2 pi nt by 60. So 2 pi n, torque equal to W minus S into effective radius divided by 60. So 2 pi into 900. So W is the load, 50 into 9.81 in Newton. So 50 kilogram is given, 50 into 9.8 minus 50 into 0.375 divided by 60 into 1000 equal to 15.56 kilowatts. Then the brake specific fuel consumption, BSFC equal to MF by BP, which is 4 divided by 15.56 equal to 0.257 kilograms per kilowatt hour. So 4 kilograms per hour, that is what the given value. And the breakdown efficiency equal to BP divided by MF into CV, which is 15.56 divided by 4 by 3600 into 44000 into 100 equal to 31.83%. So we stop here. So thank you for watching. And if you have any comment, please post the comments on the comments box in the YouTube video. And you subscribe the channel, so you will get the alert on the updation of the videos in this channel. And you can talk to me through mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject in mechanical engineering. So thank you for watching. We'll meet again in the next video with additional problems, additional questions from the GATE question paper.